It's focus, moral codes. I wonder if you're in the situation, what would you do? Big up LA. Let's go. I'm gonna make up a story, put you in a situation. There's a way about 16, let's call him Jason. Yeah, Jason was a shy boy, he was up in South London. Had good grades, bound to party Jesus, ease of abundance. School kids used to buy him off, cause he was smart. But what he didn't realise is that it had a large effect on his heart. He had enough, so he changed his image. I'll be bumping down the street with his trousers down low. Didn't want people to believe he was timid. Wanted to impress his friends, so he picked up smoking a jam with the boys in the ends. He's slowly losing the light. First he's starting with a couple school fights. He feels that this way of living is right. I know right now, you're thinking it's a minor. But let me get deeper in the story. Now he's rocking out the clothes that's a designer. He got pressured to jack some you on the street. He didn't wanna do it, but because the man them were watching, he was feeling the heat. And cause he's getting home late at night, he's losing sleep. Cause at 3 in the morning, up his stairs he has to creep. And the fences he has to leak, cause he's always on the run from police. And he carries the sharp metal in his sleeve. He says it's for protection. Mum and dad's on the verge of a breakup. He feels like he's losing affection. Now he's shutting reeds on the road. Dad left his mum and his heart's gone cold. He's got a name on the street now. He's rolling deep now. The shy boy has now become bold. And now he's banging weights in the gym because he thinks that he's too slim. And he makes so much peace from the weed that he sells that every week he can get new fresh crisps with a fresh trim. His life sounds great, innit? L-O-T. He knows that he needs to S-T-O-P. But you know what? It's too late. He started beef with the wrong boy a week before. And now he's away in the state because his face has become bait. And they know where he lives. And now they're on the way to his crib. Now he gets a loud knock on the door. One of the youths outside says, come out if you're a bad man. Jason looks, sees about 30 man damn, says, I ain't seen that before. Gets out on his knees, cries out, God, if you're there, please help me. Cause I don't wanna be in the game no more. He says, I know that you don't care, but I need you. The voice says back, I will never forsake you or leave you. Jason in amazement says, God, is that you? He heads a bang from the door. Oh no, the guy broke through. But if you wanna hear the rest of the story, then you gotta wait up for part two.